Good morning, everybody, and thank you for joining me here today. If you want to grab a Bible, we're going to start a new section of Proverbs, beginning in the 31st verse of the 16th chapter. And this section, Solomon is going to be, he spends a lot of time, as we've seen already, through the first roughly half of the book, warning his son about people to basically avoid, to be careful that they don't allow them to influence his life. Now in the next few verses, he's going to talk about some who he should be admiring, who he should be patterning his life after. He just spent the last few verses in particular, we're looking at four types of people who should be avoided. Now he's going to talk about the righteous, the wise, who should be an example to him. And beginning in verse 31, he says, the hoary or the hairy head is a crown of glory if it be found in the way of righteousness. And Proverbs, one of the, things that we see in the book of Proverbs is that teaches that that living a wise, righteous life typically means a person lives longer. Not always, but here what he's talking about is a gray-headed man, a gray-headed person. That's a crown of glory, that they've lived a long time, lived long enough to get to the point of gray hair, and that the young man should look at these people who are righteous, who have lived a righteous life for many years, grown old in their righteousness, and model his life after those people. Verse 32, he that is slow to anger is better than the mighty, and he that ruleth his spirit than he that taketh a city. And so the next person he lifts up to his son to model himself after, and we've seen this worded in various ways, is a person who is able to control their anger, who is able to control their temper, that they have power over their own spirit, that they are, he says, slow to anger. They don't fly off the handle. Then they rule their own spirit. They're in charge. They control their own emotions. And he says, these are people that you should be looking at as models, as patterns for your life. The lot is cast into the lap, but the whole disposing thereof is of the Lord. Not a tongue twister, but a little bit confusing a little bit. He's saying that this person, a lot is cast in his, he's saying this person trusts the Lord for his decisions. And what he's referring to is basically rolling dice. It's not something that we would teach today. We're taught to live by faith. We have the Holy Spirit to guide us. But in that time, they would roll or cast lots looking for God's will. Now, understand, and that practice may seem, it does seem very odd to us, but this wasn't a random game of chance. These people, when they did that, were actually demonstrating faith. They were believing that God, in his power, his sovereignty, would control the lots and therefore guide their decision. And so while to us in today's time, that may seem like a random gambling way of finding an answer, for them, this was a way of relying on God. I'm going to trust God to give me the answer through these lots. And the lesson for us is, let's not focus on the lots part of it, but again, are people who were putting their confidence in the Lord. They were trusting God. May not be the way we do it. In fact, it would be, I would recommend against using that today. But in the Old Testament, in those times, that was how they would discover the will of God. And then they would follow through on that. And so Solomon is saying, model yourself, look up to, respect those who have, who are putting their confidence in the Word of God, who are trusting Him for their leadership. Today, we don't need to cast lots. We have the leadership of the Holy Spirit, the indwelling of the Holy Spirit living in us. We have God's Word complete. They didn't have the complete Scripture that guides us. And so, different times. This man was following God. The previous ones that he talked about were those who controlled their temper, controlled their emotions, and the one who had lived a long, righteous life. He's saying, find those people and admire them, model after them, pattern your life after them, and which would bring us to the question today. I think two questions, really. One of them is, who do we look to be models, examples, mentors in our life? We all, regardless of where you are on your journey, I think all of us need someone who we look up to in that way. For example, I will tell you one of mine, and I've said this before. Many people have heard me talk about this. One of the people, and I don't even know if he knows it, is Pastor Curtis Parker. I have a tremendous respect for Curtis and for what he has done in a ministry, for the stance he has taken, for his the way he has handled his family. He's just somebody I look up to. And many times when I have a decision, especially a ministry type decision, it's a piece of the puzzle. Sometimes I've even called him and talked to him about it. But many times I'll just think through, now, how would Curtis, how do I think Curtis would handle this particular situation? We need people like that influencing our life. But then I would challenge you that we need to be influencing people with our life as well. We need to be striving to be that gray-headed righteous man. We need to be striving to be that patient, slow-to-anger man. We need to be striving to be that person who puts their confidence in God, that our children or grandchildren or others around us can see and model their life after, use as an example, as an encouragement. Hope you think about that today. Who is your model? Who is it you're looking up to? And who's looking up to you? A couple of real good questions for us today. Have a good day, and we will see you tomorrow morning.